Now, in our earlier lectures, we had used the Ginzburg-Landau theory to derive two equations, the two GL equations, and then by using these two GL equations, we could derive two fundamental length scales associated with the superconductor. These are sort of your mean field length scales that you obtain out of GL theory, which have connection to the microscopic length scales, have very close connections with the microscopic length scales, and that is the Ginzburg-Landau coherence length and the Ginzburg-Landau penetration depth, which roughly have the same meaning, which you have in the microscopic BCS theory. Okay, and we derive that, and through the GL theory, you can derive that temperature dependence very easily. Now we will use the GL theory to actually the Ginzburg-Landau equations to obtain relationships between various quantities. Okay, and these will be very useful when we discuss type 2 superconductivity and try to calculate various parameters which are associated with these type 2 superconductors. So let us try and derive a very important relation between current, flux, phase, and some of these things which are associated with a superconductor. So let us try to derive a relation between current and fluxes, essentially between current and fluxes in a superconductor, but also we will go through how the phase is related to vector potentials and fluxes and so on. We will go through these relations as we use the GL theory. Okay, so let us look at the second GL equation to start off with, which is mu naught J. Okay, I had dropped some of these factors, which are basically unit based factors. I may retain it, I may not retain it sometimes. Okay, E H cross by 2m. This is your second GL equation. Psi star gradient of psi minus psi gradient of psi star minus 2 E square by m. A into mod of psi square. Okay, now if you take psi is equal to psi naught e raised to I phi, which is the flux, and you put it in here, then you can show that mu naught, I leave that to you, it's quite easy to do it. You can show that this is equal to h cross e by m into mod of psi naught square gradient of phi, okay, minus 2 e square by m a mod psi square. Okay, now mod of psi square is equal to mod of psi naught square. Okay, it's obvious. So what we can do is that we can use it to replace this expression. So therefore mu naught J is equal to H cross by E by M mod of psi square gradient of phi minus 2 E square by M A mod psi square. And you can now divide by H cross E by M mod psi square, and then what you will get, and integrate over some closed path. You integrate over some closed path, so then you will get integral H M by H cross E mu naught J by mod of psi square dot dl is equal to integral of change of magnetic flux minus 2 E by H cross integral A bar dot dl bar. So this is over some closed path integral. So you integrate over some closed path. Okay, this is the change in phase of the wave function over the closed path This is integral of the vector potential over the closed path, which we will show is nothing else but the flux, magnetic flux associated with that closed path, and this is related to the current density. Current density integrated over the closed path. Current density integrated over the closed path. Okay. So this gives you a relation between all these different quantities. How much is the change in phase? How much is the flux associated with a path where there is a change in phase? So if there is a flux associated with some path, if there is a flux associated with some path, then the phase around that path will change. Okay. The flux, the magnetic flux is going to affect the phase of the superconducting order parameter. Okay. And if there is a current, then that also contributes to some extent to that. Okay. So this will be now what we do is we divide above expression by h2e by h cross. You divide the above expression by 2e by h cross, which is this term. Okay, you divide it out. Okay, so what you will get will be m over 2e square integral j bar dot dl bar over mod of psi square. I am for the moment dropping, okay, I am dropping this term. Okay, this is just a units term. This is equal to h cross by 2e integral of divergence of phi dot dl minus integral a bar dot dl bar. Okay. Now, integral of a bar dot dl bar around any closed loop is of course curl of a bar dot ds bar, which is so if you have any closed loop, so if this is a curved C, if this is a curve C and this is a closed loop around that, then the area integral of curl of A integrated over this area S, which is enclosed by the closed loop, is this, which is integral of b bar dot ds bar, which is the flux enclosed by the loop C. Okay, how much flux is enclosed by the loop C is going to be this magnetic flux, and integral of closed integral over the curve C gradient of phi dot dl is the total change in flux as one goes around the loop C. Okay, so as one goes around the loop C, how much is the total change in flux? Now, if you have this loop C and if you have a wave function, okay, this is your wave function, and as you go around this loop, as you go around the curve C, the wave function will of course vary as you go along this curve C, but as you go around C, the wave function psi will change, but to maintain single valuedness, suppose you start from this point, suppose you started from this point C and you went around and you came back to point C, the wave function must come back to the same value. So the phase, the flux phi, the phase phi has to change in integral multiples of 2 pi to maintain single valuedness of the wave function psi. So the net change in phase, the total change in phase that should happen as you go around this curve C and return back to the same point, this has to be, the total change has to be integral of this thing. So delta phi, which is integral of around the curve C gradient of phi dot dl, which is the net change in flux phi, has to be integral of 2 pi n to maintain single valuedness of psi. Okay, so this brings us to the expression m by 2 e square integral j bar dot dl bar over mod of psi square plus this is okay. So before I write this, this is equal to h cross by 2 e into 2 pi n minus integral of b bar dot ds bar over a surface S which is enclosed by the curve C. Okay, and this is nothing else but the magnetic flux phi, which we denoted by the capital phi. So this is the magnetic flux phi. So if I take it on this side of the equation, you can write m by 2 e square integral j bar dot dl bar divided by mod of psi square is equal to, this will become h by 2e into n. Okay, sorry, plus magnetic flux phi is h by 2e into n. Now recall, h by 2e is units of magnetic flux and it is written in terms of fundamental constants, which is h by 2e, and this is nothing else but the flux quantum phi naught. So from your GL equation you have the expression that m by 2 e square integral of j bar dot dl bar divided by mod psi square plus the magnetic flux is going to be integral multiples of the quantum of magnetic flux. I have forgotten to put this over C, mod of psi square plus this is a very important relation from GL theory. It gives a connection between currents and fluxes. This gives a relation between currents and fluxes in a superconductor. Now, in the next lecture, we will look at some of the applications of this equation, which basically relates the current flowing in a system and the fluxes with the fixed quantum of magnetic flux.